well along our investigation into the path of our raindrop, tracking it on its way back to the sea.
We've arrived at the place where many of our moving raindrops empty into the main waterway of our watershed, the Salmon River. What an amazing place this is.
Truly.
Last time, we talked about how estuaries keep our ecosystem clean and healthy.
Estuaries help to control floods and act as gigantic water filters, cleaning the water as it moves in and out with the tide.
They also provide food, shelter, and habitat for many animals and act as nurseries to raise their young.
Estuaries also trap excess greenhouse gases, like carbon dioxide, keeping them from entering the atmosphere.
Carbon dioxide is a key building block for life. Plants absorb CO2 to grow and release oxygen back into the air for us to breathe. How cool is that?
Very cool. But problems can arise when the level of CO2 accumulates in the atmosphere, faster than it can be absorbed by plants and processed into oxygen.
When this happens, excess carbon dioxide in the atmosphere traps more heat from the sun, causing the planet to warm up, which we refer to as global warming.
As the planet gets warmer and warmer, we see serious, sometimes catastrophic changes in our climate.
Again, remember, it's all about balance. Plants breathe in CO2 and breathe out oxygen. We breathe in oxygen and breathe out CO2. We depend on each other to stay in balance. The Salmon River is relatively short, only about 30 miles long. The river begins at its headwaters, over 3,000 feet up in the Central Oregon Coast Range, and flows through three counties as it moves down to the sea.
The water here is brackish, a mixture of fresh water draining from the land and salty water from the sea.
You can probably guess that the river here would be brackish because we're close to the Pacific, but brackish water can also travel miles back upriver.
This happens because salt water is much denser than fresh water, so when the tide comes in, salt water slips right under that fresh water because it's heavier.
Something else that occurs in the Salmon River is called sedimentary deposition. During winter rains, tons of sediment washes into the river, making it the color of a chocolate milkshake.
The forces of gravity prevent these sediments from making it back to the sea, causing soil and other debris washed down from the upper watershed to settle out into the estuary, where it builds up year after year. You know, usually when we find big piles of feathers like this, it seems like it was attacked. And you can especially see that from that clump right there.
You can see that the feathers were actually broken.
Yeah, there's tips broken off here. The size tells us it's a pretty large bird. These are going to be primary wing feathers that I found.
What do you got there?
Pacific tree frog.
Holy cow, look at his green.
Yeah, and he's pretty large, wouldn't you say?
Definitely, for a tree frog like him.
Yeah.
For sure. What we see today here in the Salmon River estuary is the result of the deposition of massive amounts of sediment that has happened year after year after year for thousands of years.
Try to imagine what this place looked like 20,000 years ago. Back then, the Earth was in an ice age. The ocean was 150 feet lower because billions of gallons of water were frozen and locked up in glacial ice.
Think of what would happen to the water cycle if snow fell up in the mountains but never melted and couldn't make its way back to the sea. That's exactly what happened during the Ice Age.
The Pacific coastline was located more than 4 miles further to the west than it is today. And we'd be standing high up in the mountains, looking down at a deep valley with a small creek running through it down at the bottom.
As the Ice Age ended, the ice started to melt and the level of the oceans rose. That little creek at the bottom of the valley slowed down, backed up, and turned into a river, dropping all that sediment it was carrying from higher up in the mountains.
So as the ice continued to melt over thousands of years, more and more sediment and rocks built up in the riverbed and slowly filled the valley to the very top, creating this beautiful flat meadow you see here today. We've traveled more than 3 miles from where we started our investigation at the top of our watershed.
As your raindrop to sea detector is on the ground, we've shown you lots of evidence of how our raindrop moves across the land, starting as a tiny spring, growing into larger tributaries, flowing into a lake, an estuary, and now this beautiful river.
We're following the course of the Salmon River north, where we'll see a very different type of landscape just ahead.
Our raindrop has almost completed its journey back to the ocean. Can you hear it off in the distance? Surf's up.
Okay, bye. So let's try to catch up with Alder as we move downstream to our next learning circle, where you'll see even more amazing discoveries to come.